Although our love is still special.
If you go outside, you can't go dig a hole.
Let's take a chance and
wow,
fly away.
Look at that full moon.
Somewhere.
Look at that.
Fly away.
Took a pilgrimage without a single step forth. Make a way to Allah's door while I neglect force. Try to keep my mind off of losing God to that swine force. They saying all lives matter to you stuck inside the pine box. Bury me up, bury me in seventh letter. Better get to heaven, saving seats for all the brethren. We gon' get there in a second. Yeah, I promise in the presence of a plethora of steppers for the entrance like a substitute. I make a mark and take attendance. Breach the bubble that protects us and be met with some aggression. Reach for humans and their waistbands. Turn back with a great tan, new perspective and another game plan. Not to be derailed, I cover more ground than train tracks. Still got training wheels, you couldn't even follow my path. And you can barely follow my act, comical tragedy. These days, visits to the bank sound the same as a crowd sitting in at the Laugh Factory. And these squirrels trying to get a nut, I wouldn't even feed them a seed. I don't need, fuck the tolerance, I push a team. To no limit, that's the P. If this shot kill me, then Lord willing, the clips full with my glass empty. Pull the malice, filling up my poor living. Life's a beach in Virginia, and I'm Pharrell Williams.
I had big plans for I forgot to do my flowers. I'll do that when we get back. I'll do the flowers when we get back. I had big plans for a Thoughts May Vary vlog this weekend, because I went to LA for less than a day, and that did not happen. We just, sometimes when Gabby and I get together, we need more than one day. Like, the first day is always like a catch up and work and getting everything done. And we had an interview and an event to go to and a meeting to have. And then we went on our own Valentine's date. And even in the car on our way to the event, we brought a camera thinking like, yeah, we'll vlog and just talk in the car. It did not happen. So then after the weekend, I was like, okay, I'm gonna vlog, you know, this day, meaning today. And I had all these ideas, and I found out last night that a friend of mine passed away. So we're gonna have a different day today. I'm really comfortable with grief, quite frankly. I have lost a lot of people in my life. Like, I lost my older brother when I was 13 and my dad and grandma within the same month when I was 17, and a lot of people to suicide. And so I've been around grief and I kind of know the process. And life just, Aaron and I were talking for a long time last night. Life just never wraps up with a clean bow. You know what I mean? But it doesn't take away from a relationship being special to you or meaningful for you, wherever, in whatever timeline, you know? I feel like I'm not gonna sound super prolific right now because I'm still in the middle of, I found out last night, it's the first thing in the morning, so I'm still in the middle of processing. But I'll never forget when one of my first mental health jobs, I worked at my college's counseling and psychological services, and the head psychologist there once was speaking to me about grief and reminded me that whether you're cognizant of it or not, when you go through a loss or experience a loss, your brain will go through and process all the other losses that you've experienced. So I know today will feel heavy because it won't just be about my friend in my brain. I mean, it is just about them, and I want to not make it about myself and give them the space to, I don't know how to say that. Like, I don't want to make someone else's death about myself, and I want to respect who they were and their presence and what they left and what they brought to my life. But I know my brain is gonna process through all the other losses I've had too. So I'm gonna make sure that I do some extra coping for myself today and extra things that I know makes me feel good. What I originally wanted to do today and kind of talk about more was going back to dance and like identity stuff, and especially being a dancer and trying new things and getting out of your comfort zone, because I really want to go to an adult beginner ballet class today. tonight. And I think I still will because, I don't know, mortality salience just really makes you appreciate being here and kind of remember to never act out of fear or to not let fear stop you from acting in alignment with what you really want to be doing. So I think I'll still go. I think it'll make me feel better. Anyway, we're going to be processing in real time today, I guess. I have a Thoughts May Vary interview that we're doing today. Gabby will definitely pull this interview for both of us today, but that's fine. It happens. It's about 2 hours after we woke up, so I want to take Mahal on a walk now because I want to get outside in the sunshine within the first 2 hours. Yeah, do you want to go on a walk? Okay, we'll go soon. I even small things, like I made my, my battery's gonna die. I made my coffee in like one of my favorite mugs. If you follow me on Instagram, you might have seen this. It's the rabbits doing what bunnies do mug. I have a good new book that I'm excited to read. It's The Tools. If you watched Jonah Hill's documentary on his psychiatrist, Stutz, I honestly don't remember how to say it. He wrote this book, The Tools, in collaboration with another psychologist called Barry Michaels, who I will be interviewing on a panel for a nonprofit event coming up soon. Aaron and I sit on a youth advisory board for a nonprofit called AIM Youth Mental Health, and they fund research for a lot of youth mental health innovations. It's really, really cool. And we've been doing a mind, body, soul series for a while. The last one was in October, and it was so beautiful and amazing. And this one is at the end of the month, and it's going to be at Dog Pound in LA. And there's going to be two panels, and Gabby and I are each moderating, so that's really exciting. She's going to be moderating the breathwork panel, and I'm going to be moderating the tools for self-love panel. And Barry Michaels is sitting on it, so I'm excited to dive into this, because then we'll get to talk to him later, and that will be really fun. Anyway, I still have thoughts on ballet that I want to share, but I'm gonna give myself space first, so I'm gonna drink my coffee and then go on a walk. You know, speaking of books though, because I haven't started that one yet, but this book is my new favorite book in the world. I swear, if you could deduce my entire life philosophy into a book, Rick Rubin has done it. It's so beautiful. I know I'm gonna just, this is gonna be one of those books that I'm gonna just kind of read over and over and over again for sure. What did you do? Where are you even? Oh, you're on the couch. Okay. Beauty package, so Michaela's testing stuff.
Yeah.
Fun. Honestly, this is so cute that it's different colors. This is setting spray, and then there's like little lip stuff, but that looks really targeted. But then it's kind of like Glossier, where it like, it's just a touch of, I like that.
It looks
even
really
the
good
dark
on
one. Uh-huh. Like there's no way that this makes sense that this would look good on me, this color. But it's thin.
Like, now that you have me on camera.
I know, look at her like lion's mane pop out of her. No, look, there's a perfectly good ramp. So pleased with herself. I know. You'll be the death of me. Oh, that's smelly. Thank you so much. Oh, you're so cute. Oh, just settle in on my chest. I'm so nervous. Oh my God, I'm so nervous, but I'm excited. I'm excited and I feel good. Well, I don't know if I don't know how I feel. I feel nervous and I feel happy and I feel excited. And I feel like it's inner child work. And I just hope it's not, I took an adult, wow, the sunset's pretty. I took an adult beginner ballet class 3-4 years ago. And oh my God, I cannot do this while I drive. I'll talk to you later, bye. Oh my God, it was so much fun.
Starting the podcast and sharing more online, I've been flirting with what boundaries look like for me. And in that exploration, I've kind of created this interesting dichotomy of work life, home life, that's seemingly represented in my time at home, flowing, in my routine, most of the time by myself, well, with Mahal and Aaron. And then juxtaposing that against these quick 24-hour stints of work trips up to LA that make life seem dynamic and engaging and big. And it does feel big sometimes, but most of the time, it's all just the same. The more I peek behind the curtain, the more that I realize how performative so much of this digital space is. Every once in a while, you do something great and meet genuine people and expand your perspective and get out of your comfort zone. But mostly, I'm happy with where I'm at. And I'm happy with where I'm trying to go. And I'm happy not to live at a 0 or a 10, but spend most of my days just kind of coasting at a 7 or 8, feeling in real time and basking in presence. Frankly, I'm not trying to see other people's 0s or 10s on the internet anyway. I want the daily healing, the experiences and the lessons that come from quiet, quotidian moments where seemingly nothing has changed. I want to feel other perspectives shift that rock their whole outlook, and I want to share mine. I guess that's my goal for making videos, showing myself again through art that everything is available when you're present in the here and now. And maybe showing other people too.
Hey. Eddie Chin in the house!
Croissants?
What about croissants?
These little things there?
They do kind of look like croissants, don't they? Yeah, they really do. Garlic croissant.
Garlic croissants, that's
nice. Nice. Okay, can we put one piece at a time?
Yeah. Hello? Would you like to take your mask off?
My what?
So you got a little chin strap going.
I can't, because I'm like probably the only person that's wearing on a plane anyways.
Were you really? No one wears them on planes
probably
anymore?
Probably maybe four.
Shut up. That you, little?
When you guys, I traveled here, what? 6-7 months ago, nobody had it on. I had it on, so.
Oh my God, it's so cute on you!
Baseball hats sometimes just don't work because it's
a good quality hat, that's what I'm saying, yeah. Go look at yourself in the mirror. You look very cute. Nope, this way.
Hey.
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
Okay, yeah. Should be a lot of women talking to me.
Hi. So I ended up spending the rest of the day just kind of coping and vibing and chilling. And I'll explain that, but it's like a couple days later now and I'm getting ready for my cousin's wedding. So I thought now that it's been a couple days and I kind of processed a little bit more, maybe I would talk through grief a little bit more while I try to quickly get ready. Okay, should I be like explaining the makeup I'm doing at the same time? I'm not gonna do that because I'm not a beauty gal. I don't even know how to put on makeup. But essentially, I spent the rest of the day, I went on a little walk and kind of took a moment to myself and got outside and in the sun and with my dog, which felt really nice. And then I had my own little private moment of closure, which I'm not really gonna share what I did, but it was really beautiful and honestly pretty serendipitous. There was two kind of small things that happened in that time that felt like a little message from the other side. And so it made me feel really good and brought me some closure. It just felt really nice and felt like a good kind of moment of closure for myself. And then my dear friend Michaela, who's been on the podcast, if you've listened to the podcast or if you're on our Thoughts May Vary Patreon, you obviously know Michaela. She does tarot readings for us. She's head witch and mental health professional in charge. She's always around. She also was friends with our friend that passed to the other side, and she just so happened, because she doesn't live super close to me, and she just so happened to be in the area for jury duty and got dismissed because they were like, we know you're here just to fuck the system up. Not really. They didn't even interview her and they dismissed her. But right when I got back from kind of that little beautiful serendipitous moment of closure, she called me and was like, hey, I'm actually right by your house if you're free to get a little lunch. And so we met up and had a cute little working lunch date. And it just felt good to be able to have that moment of closure and then immediately see a mutual friend afterwards and kind of share nice memories and talk through our feelings more. And it felt really, really good. And from there, from Michaela being here, I went straight to ballet. And then after ballet, met up with Aaron for a little celebratory beer. Our friend that passed loved beer. Celebratory sounds awful. I mean, celebrating the fact that I went to ballet and also a beer for our friend. So we got a little beer, and then I immediately picked up my uncle because now my whole family's in town for this family wedding. So anyway, I think going back to kind of what I was saying before, I know that when people pass and I'm gonna be processing grief, I'm gonna be processing through all the losses I've ever experienced. So I expect to have stuff about my dad be brought up and my brother and my grandma and, you know, friends that I've lost. So I know that my brain is going through that. So like I said, like making sure I have added layers of coping and also really working through those feelings in real time is so important to me. So like right after I found out, the night that I found out, Aaron and I stayed up talking for like 2.5 hours. So immediately processing in real time, taking the time to kind of get outside because I know that makes me feel really good, and process and then have my own little moment of closure was also really important to make me feel better. And then meeting up with like a mutual friend that understands what you're going through or your loss and talking that out. And then it just so happened I had already had that ballet class planned, but it felt really, really nice to do something. And then I had already had that ballet class planned, but I did end up going and it felt so nice to just kind of do something with my body and move through my body, especially because I grew up as a dancer. That kind of like inner child love came back out. If you ever danced and stopped, you know exactly what I mean. Like it felt so good and just kind of ended up being such a good day that I really, really needed that. And it brought so much nourishment back to my soul. And even Aaron said something to me. I was nervous before I went, obviously. And when I went, but as I was leaving, I told Aaron, oh my God, I'm so nervous. And he said, that's good, that means you're alive. And I remember thinking like, wow, damn, that's a poignant thing to say today, but it's true. Like death is just such a part of life. I feel because I have known so many people that passed, I feel like the veil is so thin. I kind of feel like I'm around them all the time. It doesn't feel like they're gone forever. We're all gonna be on that other side quicker than we know it. I really feel like I interact with people in my own unique, special way that have passed. And I don't mean like weird stuff. I just mean like beautiful little special moments. Hey, please, for the love of God, in drag. It's my favorite Ram Dass quote. We're all God in drag. That, come on, that's so fucking funny. Oh, I forgot to put on the fucking primer. Whatever, it doesn't matter, I put on so much skincare. Anyway, ballet was so much fun. I went and it was only, so there's like a first part of the class and a second part of the class, and I could only go to the first part today, or the day that I went, because I had to go pick up my uncle from the airport. But it was so much fun. It was like me and two other older people, and it was so fun and felt so good to move my body, and it felt very judgment-free. The last time I went to an adult beginner ballet class, they took themselves so seriously, and them being the teacher and the other students, and no one introduced themselves to me, and I was a brand new student. Everyone else had been there, and I remember thinking like, it's just fucking rude. Like, we're all old. Like, this is weird. So it was so much fun to go somewhere that was like welcoming and fun and sillier and You know, just doing things for the joy of it. Just felt so good. Like anyone, I feel like anyone that's ever been a dancer knows, like that never leaves as part of your identity, no matter how long it's been. Like I haven't danced professionally in 15 years. And so, oh my God, it just was so, so, so good and nice. And real, like it really, really was inner child work. Anyway, kind of distracted because I'm running on a tight timeline, but I think I just wanted to say that grief, people say time heals all wounds, and it really doesn't, at least for me. I found that time kind of creates space around the grief to hold it in your heart along with everything else that's going on in there. It truly never leaves. I think about my dad every fucking day. I'm sad that I'm not with him every fucking day, but it has always felt like he's just on an out-of-country business trip and didn't get the right phone plan. Like, I feel like he's so close and around, I just can't ring him up right now. And I really think that's a testament to, like, the work I've done, and also, where is my beauty sponge? And also just that perspective of knowing, like, we're all gonna get there eventually. You know what I mean? We're all here together. We're all just walking each other home. So I can't really think. Maybe this was not the best idea to try to do this at this time, because I really can't think right now. Anyways, hell of a YouTube comeback, am I right? It's honestly all Gabby's idea. Tell me you're a Taurus vlogging. Oh my God.
She's back. We're so happy.
Gabby, I've wanted to be a YouTube girly since I fucking found out about YouTube in 2005. Like, I've been trying to make videos since high school. Not really, but I've wanted to be on YouTube for forever because it's my favorite. But Gabby really was like, we really need to vlog for Patreon because we've been saying we're gonna do that forever and we never did. And so we, now that we're doing that, we both wanted to come back to our own respective YouTube channels too. And it's just been the fucking best. Like, I'm so glad that she's making us do this. You know what? I'm gonna set like every stage in between. And I'm gonna talk more later because this is not working out for me and I wanna feel cute and get ready to go and vibe. Oh, but I also wanted to say, like, being with family was also really nice. And like, I felt like what helped me through it a lot was a really good mix of healthy distraction and also processing in real time. Like, I really balanced conversations, processing, healthy distraction. Like, having this big conversation with Aaron, going on a walk. Having my moment of closure and speaking and talking to Michaela, going to ballet class, getting a beer. Then having my family here, being able to talk to them about it and then also be in their presence and kind of vibe and appreciate that I am here right now. So, just be here now, baby. And I'm gonna be here now by leaving. Okay, love you, bye. Can't pass till I reach 27, 25, all right.